Hi, my name is Ksenia, and we're digging into the secrets of Charleston 20's. Here comes the king, my favorite part, honestly, of the cow tail. And that move looks like this. So let's break it down, the technical part. I truly, honestly believe, and that's my sincere philosophy, that in order to do cow tail purely 360 with no falling or disturbance in your eyebrows, you gotta work with the lower part of your body completely. So actually divide your body on two parts. Upper part is a part that's gonna be gorgeous, drinking coffee and smoking a cigarette, or just beautifying the space, and the lower part is gonna do all the hard and giant work. This is our initial position. Say we want a cow tailing with our right leg. The whole weight, 300% of the time, is gonna be on your left leg. We have a preparation of our twist, because twist is the engine of cow tail. Here we go, this is our basic step. 8, 1, 2, 3, 8, 1, 2, 3, 8, 1, 2, 3. Few little secrets. First, my knees, once I'm moving my tail behind, are one behind another. That would give me more beautiful shape visually, and that will give me as well a freedom to tail 360 in the back without any disturbance. Yes, to create actually this circular momentum. Second, swing your hips to the back. As we said in the very beginning, that's very important to swing your hips to the back just in order to give the movements bigger amplitude. And as well, you have to give a space for your leg to twirl like a propeller in the back. So, we have two twists on our left leg happening while doing this swinging movement back in the back. Twist inside and twist outside. And this is as many twists that we will have to remain while keeping the circular momentum. The next thing is that you gotta, for ladies, for example, imagine you have a dress with a long, long tail and you wanna lift it up, for example. Hop, hop, yeah? Or imagine there's something here on the floor that you wanna sweep, yeah? Sweep. So your foot is relaxed and you're aiming as far as possible to your left at this point. Whap. This is your first movement. Whap. From here, you're just showing a trajectory with your leg. Where is this 360? So you basically go wakatakatakataka, wakatakatakata. The weight is still 360 degrees on your left leg. And then you try and show it a little bit faster. One, two. One and two. One and two, one and two, one and two. My sister loves this movement very much, and she always says, oh, Ksenia, this funny movement that you do, the cow tail. And she starts showing to me like that, which is obviously has nothing to do with the real cow tail as we understand. But what's the problem here? And this problem happens very often, is the placement of your knee. Yeah, so your knee is not here in the universe around your body. It's right behind your other knee. So, like scissors, yeah? Imagine this is your connection, the scissors. What else? Yeah, as I said, the weight is completely on the leg you're standing on. So, you know, trust yourself that for 40 hours, you can do that without falling to any outside. Yeah, so have quite a good core here, you know, 16-pack, stability. Add a little bit of your bounce and make them two. One, two, a five, six, seven. One, a two, a five, six, seven. The mirror is your best friend in practicing cow tail, because we want to avoid cheating. And the cheating would be all possible variations of half circle, one and a quarter, and all the other, you know, something like this would be cheating, yeah? Because we want to see the contour, yeah? We want to see all the beauty of it. Switch the leg, so try to do everything on the right, the same technique, the same idea, and this would be our beginning of cow tail, and I'll tell you about more variations in the next one.